What's up, everyone? Welcome back to After the Storm. Welcome back to the NHL 07 Dynasty Mode series. We are back with episode number 12 of the series. A matchup here against the Boston Bruins, who are kind of in the middle of the pack here in a very tight Atlantic division. Are we Northeast right now? I think we're Northeast division right now. Very tight, packed Northeast division right now. A team we faced at least, I think we've played them just once this season. Am I wrong on that? Yeah, just the one time, a 9-1 victory, again, a lopsided one back in episode, what would that have been, 8 or 9? Like, that one's actually recent, like, kind of, I don't know why I'm blanking on it, but I just can't remember it all that well. Either way, we're coming off an 8-3 win against the Atlanta Thrashers in our last episode. Miller's going to get a couple more starts in a row here. We're really focusing on him in terms of kind of what we need to do, what we think we're going to have to do with our goaltending situation. We're hopeful that he's going to get himself back on track and start really putting up some good numbers. But with that said, it's a work in progress for sure. So with that said, let's just go ahead and get into the preview of our matchup here with Boston. So going over both teams right now, 87 to 88 overalls. Again, very tight in almost every single category. Realistically, we're about the same, given we're an 88 when we're at home. It's not too much difference for our squad versus theirs. So again, in terms of roster construction, a very similar team. 5.64 goals for, again, that's not something we anticipate will be sustainable throughout the season, but we've been putting up really good, solid offensive numbers these last few games. 3.82 goals against. That is what we want to drop. We want to see us be a little bit better in terms of our defense. We have made some shifts and some changes and stuff, but there might be a few more in store as we go through. Again, if we're still seeing that these high goals against are happening and we're coming out on the losing ends of some games where we should probably just have a little bit better goaltending, we'll make some shifts in the lineup if that continues to happen. Our goaltending matchup here, Tim Thomas, 89 against Ryan Miller, 88. Again, Miller, 2 stars across the board, no matter what, if he's on the road or at home. Tim Thomas has a few 3-star categories. He's a very good goaltender. Even at this time, he was a good goaltender for the next like 5 years in real life here. Kind of comes out of nowhere at one point in that 2011 Bruins run where he was just incredible right toward the end of his career. It's tough. The last time we played Boston, they weren't good. They really weren't. We just destroyed him 9-1. I think it was something where toward the end of the game it just became a rout, but it's a matchup that, again, this isn't a team we can take lightly, even on a 9-1 first meeting of the season. Not something we can take lightly. We have to come in and play some of our best hockey here. Going to their team report, the team that gave Atlanta, I should say, their first win of the season, the Boston Bruins, 6-5-0. Their home record 1-3. We're on the road in Boston for this one, so that is a good sign for us. They are coming off that 3-2 loss. Again, very similar goals for, goals against for their squad. And we're getting a full team, full health in this one. I'm not sure if the first meeting of the 9-1 victory from a few episodes ago was a full squad or not, but nevertheless, again, we're going in against a full, healthy Bruins team in a game that I don't expect us just to walk all over them. Unlike the other matchup, I think they'll come back and be very competitive against us. But with that said, guys, let's not wait around any longer. We'll go ahead and we'll get into our matchup here. Game number 12 of the season against the Boston Bruins. Here in Boston, we are ready for puck drop. Bruins, Sabres, a Northeast Division clash here. Sparta going to win that opening draw. No changes to the Sabres lineup. Coming off an 8-3 win against the Atlanta Thrashers in Boston. On the other hand, coming off a 3-2 loss to the Atlanta Thrashers, giving them their first win of the season for the 15th-ranked team and bottom-ranked in the NHL. Last meeting between these two squads as Briere dances his way in. Gets checked off the puck by Slager. First meeting, 9-1 rout by the Buffalo Sabres in this one. We expect this one to be much tighter, much closer in terms of competitiveness in this one. Here's Vanaganov, Briere, Vanek coming into the zone. Kubina's going to wrap it around the boards and Briere will be first two. Briere finds a Vanaganov. Good passing there. Vanek shot. Big save early on for Tim Thomas. Vanaganov. Vanek again shot off the post and Char is there to collect it. Bruins fans letting their team know. There's a Finneganov, makes a move. Slager, good stick. Finds Mark Savard. He's got a step. Savard in. Ooh. Gets his stick checked there. Oh, yeah, back checking Brian Campbell. And here comes Briere. Pass across. Tried it a little early and hit Slager's skate. Mark Savard. Bergeron in front. Murray missed the pass. Campbell wraps it around for his D partner, Kubina. Vanek. Coming back into the zone. Finds a Finneganov. Back to a Finneganov. Shot. Saved by Tim Thomas. They play it out to Bergeron. Open on the right wing. Here comes Savard. Back and forth they go. Savard shot. Glove saved by Ryan Miller. It's a big save early on for him. 5 minutes without a whistle to start this one. Connolly down low. Finds Derek Roy. Roy shot. Hits the crossbar. Chances early for Buffalo. Sturm. Acquired in the Joe Thornton trade that sent Thornton to San Jose. Pass up ahead. Connolly. Connolly below the goal line finds Roy, and his shot just goes over the net. But Roy retrieves. Back and forth. Here's Dumont. Hat trick in the last game. Shot on. Big save there. The Bruins come away with the puck. Sturm. Back working against Teppo Dumanin. He finds space. Finds Donovan, and that's a good pad save by Miller. The boy still has the puck. He tried to wrap play, and Miller dove onto the puck. Look at the Boston lineup here tonight. ...12:22 to go in the first. Jury on the draw. He gets that win. 1-2 forming here. Jury with a move. A couple goals in the last game, including a shorthanded marker. Lacouture. Our corner dump. Tchaikovsky there first. Backhander on, actually. Kind of fooled Miller, but he fought it off. Jury finds Jochen Hecht. Hecht. Kotalik. Jury. Shot. Save. There by Tim Thomas. Jury coming back the other way. Kotalik. Kotalik. Cross. Jury. Shot. Oh, and he goes wide. Trying to lift that into the top corner from an oncoming Tim Thomas. Here's your Chyna. Chyna Moran, Jamnov, playing it back at the point. Lacouture down low, got the backhander off, and it's a good save for Miller as we have a bit of a goaltender's duel to start. Hecht. Lidman, Kotalik. Kotalik over. Lacouture intercepting that one. Fans eagerly waiting for a goal. Their Bruins team. Here's Kotalik. Backhander on. Good save by Thomas. Thomas has been sharp early on. Here comes Hecht. He's bumped off, and Lacouture is going to bring it back the other way at the end of his shift here. Plays it down low to the board. Spot check there first. Kotalik, nice move. Here's Jury in the slot. Hecht. Another. Good save for Tim Thomas as we hit 7 minutes in a quick-moving first period here. Here's Jamnov below the goal line. He's going to bring it out. Shot. Owen Miller has sunk into his net, making sure that there was no opportunity for a short side play. Take a look. No lineup changes. For this Buffalo team, Briere back out against Savard. Top lines against each other. Briere going to win that draw. Briere, nice move to get around Savard, but runs into the big wall known as Big Z Zdeno Chara, signed in the offseason. He offers a free agent from the Ottawa Senators. Miller being sharp early on. Briere, the draw win shot, turns and fires, and a good save up high by Tim Thomas. Vanek below the goal line. Briere back in front. Good play. Pitch and catch there from Briere and Vanek. So that puck will go all the way down the ice. And with just under 5.5 to go here in the first, we have an icing. That'll bring it back to the Bruins zone. Word for Ryan Miller early on in the season has been consistency. looking for more of it out of him. Savard in clean and fight for the puck. Savard's in. Big shot scores on the rebound. Mark Savard. Stripping clean into the puck. Stayed there for the rebound. Got it past Miller. And the Bruins open the scoring. Late in the first. Boy's going to win that draw. Gostad. Fourth line out here for the Sabres. Here's Brad Boys. Shakes off the check. Leach, Sturm. Shot. Oh, he tried a spin move and turned right back out to Sturm. That one, Miller's going to send away. That one looked like it hit the side of the net. Pominville back the other way. Nice move there. Still with the puck. Shot on. Big pad save by Tim Thomas on Jason Pominville. Come the Bruins again. Sturm. Sturm still with the puck. Finally loses it. Excellent work by Marco Sturm. Stan Paillet. Paillet. Sturm. Onovan. Boys. Sturm in front. Puck battle there. And Kleinen finally comes in to clean it up. We'll send it down the ice. And a race here. Leach will get there first. It up for the icing. Key draw here late in the first. Minute 50 to go in the Buffalo end. Down 1-0. Here's Gostad. Paul Gostad wins that draw. He's going to bring it out himself. He's one-on-one, him and Slager. His pass is broken up. Back the other way it comes. Savard, the goal already. Glenn Murray shot, tried to go 5-hole and a good save there. Trying to go 5-hole on Ryan Miller, and Ryan Miller makes sure. And he's got that one. Briere against Stastny. Final minute of the first. Briere will work his way out. Briere turns it over to Stastny. There's turnover right back, and Vanek with the backhand chance on. And Tim Thomas fantastically there to get that save. Seconds left on the clock here in the first. Hard during the zone. Backhander on. It's a save for Miller. Heshed, but time will expire as he had a jump. Bruins will take a 1-0 lead into the first break. Goal by Mark Savard on his own rebound is the difference maker so far. We'll be back with the second period in just a moment. Back for the second period. Shots 10-9 in favor of the Sabres in that first frame. Excellent goaltending on both sides, but just the one goal on the rebound for Mark Savard, the difference maker so far. Savard tried to work in against Pavel Kubina there. Vanek back and forth with a Finneganov, and it's broken up, and Therese Bergeron will bring it back out. Finds Glenn Murray streaking around the other wing. Bergeron shot scores! Patrice Bergeron. Perfectly placed snapshot. Just past the pad of Miller off the inside of the post. In an early strike in the second period for the Bruins, opens up a 2-0 lead. John Donovan. That was blocked back to the corner. It works by Numanen. Dumont coming off the hat trick in last game, looking to get that performance going. Here's Derek Roy. His pass picked off by Stewart. Boy's bringing it back the other way. Boy's working his way in. Nice move. Tried to go 5-hole on a modified wrap chance there, but Miller stands tall. Connolly gets around the defender. Connolly again. Oh, his centering pass is broken up by Tim Thomas. Take a look at Bergeron's 2-0 marker here. Perfectly placed shot. Briere winning the draw. backhander on, geared to the corner perfectly by Tim Thomas. Here comes Savard working against Kubina. Kubina, good effort there. Breer is going to find Vanek. Vanek takes the hit. He stays with it. Tries short side on Tim Thomas, and that won't work. Tim Thomas has been on his game so far. Here's Bergeron to Savard. Scores! 3-0 Bruins. Top line. Carrying the load. And that is just a perfect deke and pass by Patrice Bergeron to find a streaking Mark Savard. Back off the draw, Jury, as the Bruins had begun running away with this one. Jury, nice moves inside, but a great save by Tim Thomas. A penalty upcoming. That's going to send the Bruins to the power play as Chris Jury is going to go off for hooking. Jury just trying to get ahead of Zhamnov on the back check, and it's going to get called quite a bit, especially with these new rules. Bruins to the power play. 2 minutes, their first power play of the evening. Here comes Brad Boyes. Boyes shot. No, he won't get it off. Back in front, Sturm. Oh, he hits the post. It goes into the corner, but Boyes is going to retrieve that first. Stewart, Tchaikovsky, Sturm. Oh, good passing play there, but Sturm just missed it wide. First 30 seconds of the power play is over. Sturm, back in front, tries another chance. Back down the ice it goes, and Slegger turns it over to Roy, and Roy gets a backhander off, but another solid save by Tim Thomas as minute 7 remains on the power play for the Bruins. Alstead on the draw. He'll win it. Turned over, though, to Chara. Bruins will come back the other way with it. Pass is offside as it came back over the line. Tale of two very different games so far for these two squads playing each other so far this season. Buffalo taking a 9-1 win in their first matchup. That one is offside yet again. The Bruins are having difficulty starting up in their own end, or as they enter that offensive zone. But yes, 9-1, Buffalo winning that first matchup of the season, and the Bruins have really come back and shown that game early in the season, it was maybe a one-off. Savard just danced in, and Miller with a fantastic pad save there. 35 seconds remain in the power play. Bergeron and Murray. That one's picked off by Kubina, and he's going to dump it back down. Savard starts it back. 2 goals in the game. Looking for the hat trick. Is Mark Savard. Bergeron finds Murray in front, and that is a huge save for Miller as he's going to need to be perfect from here on out. Give his team a chance to get back into this game. Here comes Savard. Turned over to Kubina. Gostad up the wing. Gostad shakes the check. Looking in front. Oh, he was looking for Jury out of the box, but Hash got the puck there. Good pad save by Thomas again. His rebound control has been phenomenal tonight. Savard shot on, steered to the corner. Miller. Jury, Hash, and Gostad. Jury backing it up to Hesh, but an oncoming Bruin steals the puck. Bergeron finds Leach at the point. Chara, Leach, Chara again. Pitch and catch, D to D at the point. Still with it. Having no problems here as the Buffalo forwards are not stepping up. Oh, there, finally it is. Chara and Leach still playing with it as the Sabres seem to just be content to watch, and Chara rips a shot wide. And will Jury win the race to that puck? He will. Jury in. Shot. Big save by Thomas after all that. The Bruins will start it back. Bruins Leach. Shot from the point. Goes wide. Chara still out there. Plays it down the boards to Murray. Chara, point shot, blocked. Lacouture bringing that puck away from Yaro Spacek. Hits a stanchion, drops. 6 minutes to go in the second. Buffalo needing to get themselves on the board. Heading into this third period. Here's Jury, a shot, two chances. Big saves again by Tim Thomas. He has come to play tonight. Jamnov with a... Not sure if he knew he had so much open ice there. He's spun back looking for a pass option. Connolly to the half board. Shot hits the side of the net. Sharp angle. Tchaikovsky. Low, Maroš Tchaikovsky over across to Jamnov. Two whacks at it. Big saves by Miller. Jamnov back into the zone. Come the Bruins. Roy. Spins off. Roy still got the puck. Roy knocked over there by Moran. Lacouture on the other side, but that one is offside as Tchaikovsky was ahead of the play. 3:14 to go here in the second. Sabres win the draw there. The next matchup for the Leafs tomorrow night. Or sorry, not for the Leafs. Well, technically for the Leafs, but for the Sabres tomorrow night against the Leafs. Another Northeast Division matchup. Slated. Stastny shot. Steered to the corner by Miller. Back to the point. The Bruins defender bringing it back through. Here's a Finneganov now as this top line gets a chance to come back out and work. There's a Finneganov. No shot there. Approach the final minute here. Finneganov. Shot on. Big save. Finneganov first to the puck. Briere shot, another save. Tim Thomas has been stellar tonight. It's Gerald. Down low. Final seconds here of the second. This will likely do it. Finneganov won't have an opportunity to shoot the puck. Nevertheless, we go to the intermission. 3-0. Bruins lead. Bergeron and Savard the goals in the period. A lot of work to do for Buffalo, and mainly finding a way to beat Tim Thomas. We'll be back with the third. Shots even, scores not. 3-0, Boston leading. Savard's got two, Bergeron's got one. Top line has been tremendous for the Bruins in this one. Not to mention their starting goaltender. Here's Vanek, he's got a step. Here comes Thomas Vanek. Tried to go five hole, and Thomas again standing tall against an oncoming Thomas Vanek. Derek Roy. Brad Boyd's bringing it back the other way. Stopped up by Kalinin there, and Sabres will turn it back. Here comes Connolly. Connolly in. Tries a move. Good poke check there by Tim Thomas. Sturm down low. Finds Boys and a good paddle. Paddle down save. 2-1-0 the other way. Connolly shot. Great save again by Tim Thomas as he's been perfect throughout this game. Boys on the half boards. Looks across. Finds Donovan. Good glove save by Miller, who's been no slouch himself. Derek Roy, peeking his way in. Roy finding Connolly. Connolly won't get the shot off, and Newman in. Ooh, shoots that one after the whistle. Newman just could not keep that puck on the side. 16:28 to go here in the third. Draw one by the Bruins. Chara bringing it up. Top line. Savard here looking for the hat trick. Murray shots blocked by Kubina. Briere. backhander on Vanek. Oh, and his rebound shot goes wide, but Campbell brings it back to the point. Fitaganov shot scores. And Buffalo finally finds its way onto the score sheet. As Maxima Fitaganov, what a play there against Glenn Murray, who was doing it a check, dropped himself, the puck turned around, had a little bit of extra time, picked his corner. And ends the shutout streak of, or sorry, I should say, the shutout bid for Tim Thomas tonight. Jury off the draw win. Yurchina back there. Stripped of the puck. Lacouture going to dump it around the boards. Lacouture wins the race there. Cherkovsky off the side of the net. Nash bringing it back the other way. Third line out for the Sabres here. Kotalik, Jury, backhander by Jury goes wide. 15 minutes to go. Here's Hesch turning it over. Hesch back and forth. Jury scores! Some excellent defensive work by this third line. And they get rewarded as the rebound off of Hesch's shot. Say that one 10 times fast. Hesch shot. Rebounded Jury and he buries it. Just like that, we've got a game here, folks. Savard winning the draw. 3-2 the score. Savard in, backhander on, and a good fought, fighting that save by Ryan Miller, but Murray right back goes wide. Panic. Here. Rear's pass is tough to get through. 6'9" defenders, it ain't O'Chara. Slegger, Savard, backhander goes wide. Chara at the point, though, will retrieve. Chara, Savard, shot blocked by Kubina. Excellent play there. 12 minutes to go here in the third. Sabres looking to tie. Panic, down low, Briere, shot, it's blocked by Slegger. Murray, across the ice to Savard. Campbell, shoves Murray, gets the puck and retrieves it back out, but it's turned over in the neutral zone. And again, turned over, and that one going to be offside. We have 11 minutes to go here in the third period that suddenly become much more interesting after two quick Sabre goals. Derek Roy winning that draw. He'll bring it in the speedster, Derek Roy. Roy across the ice, finds Connolly, shot. And they pick five hole on Tim Thomas, and that won't go. Boys back the other way. Boys across to Donovan, scores. And a good pass there from Brad Boys along the half wall, and Sean Donovan makes no mistake, places it perfectly against Ryan Miller, sliding left to right, and the uphill climb gets a little bit higher. Jury in. Good chance there, but Thomas. Owen dumped down the ice, but not enough for icing. Turned over to Cherkovsky. Spot check. Spot check dumps it around the boards. Lidman on the other side. Pass across to Kotalik. Kotalik shot on. Hesch, another chance. Thomas turns away both. Bajek below his own goal line finds Jury. Jury made it a one goal game for just a short period of time. Can he do it again? Here's Jury again. Shot. That one blocked by Yurchina in front of the net. 7:45 to go here in the third. Buffalo looking to get back within one. Here's Cherkovsky with the puck. Lacouture shot blocked by Kotalik. Back it comes. Jury. One on one against Yurchina. Looks for an outlet. His pass intercepted by Cherkovsky. Kamenov brings it back. Battling against Lidman. He's going to turn it over. Another chance is a 2-on-2 forming with Jury, who's hit by Yurchina. Cherkovsky. Kamenov. Kamenov shot. Oh, and spot check. Had to clear that one out. And that one nearly off his own goaltender. As Kotalik is going for that one. Hesch scores! Oh, and a bit of a broken play. And Kotalik won the race against Lacouture at the end of his shift, and Hesch while getting hauled down, gets that backhander underneath the glove of Tim Thomas. And now again, with 5.5 to go here in the third, we've got a game. Can the Sabres close up this gap? Campbell pressed up against Bergeron, and that forced the turnover. Vina across the ice to the captain, Daniel Briere. And again off by Slegger. Kubina there finds Vanek. Vanek tried to pass right as he entered the zone, and Chara picked that one off. That one's offside. 4:05 to go here in the third. Savard winning the draw just outside the Buffalo zone, but quickly Buffalo regains the possession. Here's Briere. Shot on. Good save by Thomas and Chara there. He is just going to ice that puck. Campbell back to retrieve. We'll have a draw with 3:23 remaining in the third. A 4-3 Boston lead. Briere winning the draw. He's going to turn. Find his spot. Good shot. Thomas there again. Finneganov. Tried his shot, it was blocked. He was looking to use the screen to the Bruins player. Back, Briere into the zone. Picked off by Slegger. Slegger. Down low, Bergeron. Turned over to Kubina. Minute 45 to go here. Finneganov. Briere, shot scores! And another broken play that ends up in the back of the net as Chara went down for the block and Briere pulled that puck across the body of Chara. And with a minute 36 and an uphill climb in this third period on two separate occasions, the Buffalo Sabres have tied this game as Stewart is going to ice it again. And the Bruins are on their heels. A minute 8 to go here in the third. What a sequence of events in this game. 3-0 entering the period. Two quick goals by the Sabres in the first 10 minutes. Here's Roy off the draw. Kalinin, Numanen. Roy walking in, shot. It goes high. Stewart, Donovan, who made it 4-2. Here comes Dumont. He's been quiet tonight. Three goals in the last game against Thrashers. And Donovan's going to win the race for the icing. 35 to go here in the third. Dumont to Roy. Eric Roy hit by Stewart, and it's going to come the other way. Donovan has got a goal already. Picked off by Numanen. Turned back over to Sturm. Good effort to get the puck. Scramble in front. 20 seconds to go. Kalinin is going to bring that one out and finds Roy on the wing. Roy looking in front for someone. Dumont. Dumont still in front. Backhander scores! And with 11 seconds to go in this third period, JP Dumont with a backhander. What a backhander, top shelf over the shoulder of Tim Thomas. Not done yet here. Savard's coming back. Thomas to the bench. Savard with the puck. Bergeron in front. Briere's going to get that puck. It's going to come out of the zone. The Sabres are going to have a miraculous comeback on the road in Boston and take this 5-4. After entering the third period down 3-0 and at one point trailing 4-2 about halfway through the game or halfway through the period. What a miraculous, incredible comeback and a show of resiliency by this Buffalo team. And as always, we will leave you with the three stars of tonight's matchup and join you on the next Sabres broadcast. honestly, I don't know what else you can ask for in terms of a game. That was awesome. That was a fantastic comeback game, and overall a very fantastic game. Just quickly going through it, even when the Bruins went up 3-0, I was like, this game is toast. Like, they're getting nothing generated. Thomas looked incredible. Even in saying that, when the 3-0 goal went in, I was like, none of these goals are really on Miller. And Miller gave us a chance to win. Probably want him to have the Donovan goal back, but even then, he played well enough to give us the win. And that's all that matters. That's the kind of performance we want to see out of Ryan Miller. He kept us in it when we started battling back. Unfortunate to go back down 4-2, but it's a good play by Boyes over to Donovan there. But honest to God, the most incredible thing is just the resiliency of this team. Like, they always are back, ready to go, trying it, and usually they get another goal very soon after anything. So, an incredible comeback in general. Briere to score that goal against... There's an element of, like, the hitboxes, like, I'm going to call it a hitbox as a video game term, but, like, the actual space that a 6'9" player like Zdeno Chara takes up in this video game is quite a bit. Even if he's not poke checking or on the ice or throwing a hit or something, just shooting the puck is difficult. Passing the puck, we saw that a bunch of times with Briere trying to pass the puck around Chara, it just didn't work. To get that shot off and get it past Thomas to tie the game is incredible. And then just that second line coming out, and that newly put together second line of Dumont, Connolly, and Roy has just worked wonders ever since. And it's fantastic to come out of that game and see a Finneganov and Thomas Vanek on a hot streak. It's just fantastic to see. Taking a look at our next matchup, Toronto is coming off a 4-3 win against the Florida Panthers in their last game. As always, we want to check in on any of the teams when we're about to play them. So as we jump back to the standings here, as we can see, Toronto is in fourth in the conference right now. However, they've played 16 games already. They've played a lot of games early on in this season. So no surprise there, but they're 8-6-2. So they're essentially 500, whereas we're 8-1-3. We're in doing pretty well at this point. It's another pivotal matchup where, man, Boston losing out on those 2 points was quite something, honestly. What a comeback against that team, really. Just truly what a great comeback that was. Seems like we have some mail, so let's go ahead and check out what we've got. So two things, we got a farm team player. Just consider calling up Jeff Gilson. He'd be quite an asset to the team. Again, I don't think Gilson would do much. Oh my God. I've never seen this. Like, even trying to recount, like, playing NHL 7, I love this. So, Jury, if you guys have watched the whole series up to this point, we've talked extensively about, yeah, Jury might be the guy to go. Like, he's going to be, you know, he's a high overall. He's probably going to have decent trade value in this game. And he's right now, he's our third line center. Just because he slid down from the second line. And, but he's been good on the third line. I've had no issues with that third line of him. Hesh and Kotalik, like, I think they've produced pretty well. But him is saying this, don't trade me yet, is his subject line. That's crazy. Sorry about my play, I guess, is a subject line. But we've both seen my numbers, and I've had a heart-to-heart with the coach, too. I just want you to know that I'm committed to winning here with this club in this city. Please don't take my recent performance as any sign that I'm not with the program. It's just a dry spell that I'm working my way through. Sincerely, Chris Jury. That might have bought... That might have bought Chris Jury some time. Again, he's not been bad. Like, let's quickly just jump to the player stats. We'll just go look at our team. Jury has 12 points in 12 games. He is a point per game player. He's been even. That's probably been the biggest knock on him, is it seems like when his line is on the ice, we are giving up goals. And it seems like when Briere, Vanek, and Finneganov are on the ice, we are not, and we're scoring a ton. So the biggest knock on Jury right now is that his plus minus isn't great, but he's a point per game player right now on a team that is, in terms of offense, really doing well. So, and it's not like I'm not downplaying it by any stretch here. He's been very good. And I don't really have any knocks against Drury at the moment. He's fitting perfectly into this third line role. He might have bought himself some more time. He might just be permanently our third line center because there's other guys that can be moved. But overall, that's a really cool email to get. Dan Paille has played 12 games and has no points. he's the only guy who doesn't have a point, but basically has played no minutes in this. But nevertheless, that's pretty cool to see. I like those little features, again, stuff that the old games did so very well that the current games don't do well. Players just saying like, oh, I'm not playing great or whatever. And again, he is playing pretty good. Could he be better? I'm sure of it. But that's really cool to see. So let's go ahead and jump into our next matchup here. Let's preview ourselves against the Toronto Maple Leafs, a rivalry. Here we go. So taking a look at both squads, again, the goaltending clearly a disadvantage for the Leafs at 81. However, across the board, 87, 88, we are relatively the same. Offense and defense for both teams, very, very much the same. But we should have the advantage in net. Taking a look, 56% points percentage for the Leafs. Again, they've played a lot of games so far this season. 2.69 goals for isn't too good. 2.81 against, again, I think they're getting the benefit of having played so many games in this season so far. Odds are they're probably not this good of a team. 06-07, I don't recall if they made playoffs in 06-07. I don't think they did. I think the first time they make playoffs is like 2013 during the lockout shortened season. Overall, this is a game I feel like we can win, especially with the goaltending. Again, goaltending against our team that is just heavy on offense right now, plus we're at home, I expect a win here. And our goalie profile, as we mentioned before, Ryan Miller staying in the net. No reason for me right now to bring him out. He played very well in the game against Boston, gave us a chance to win, and our guys did it. Put on that performance in front of him again, 2 stars across the board. Andrew Raycroft on the other side, 82. This is a goaltender we should be able to pick apart. Really, really should be able to pick apart. Like I said, I expect to win here. And our team reports, overall, taking a look at the Leafs, they are a little bit worse on the road than they are at home. 3-3-2, so they're just about 500, 5-3 at home, so they're a little bit better when they're at home. 43 goals for, 45 against, again, very similar numbers. And they're coming off this 4-3 win against Florida in their last game. Now, these players aren't too far away from returning, but I believe the game doesn't have like playable injuries or anything like that. So Hal Gill and Matt Stajan again, so bottom six forward, probably. I want to say probably Gill is like their third pair D, maybe second pair D at this point. So they're missing a defenseman and a forward. But again, none of these players should be super consequential to the Leafs in this game. As I forgot to mention, actually, Kubina. This is Kubina's first game against the Leafs since we traded for him. So hopefully he comes out and has a good game against the Leafs, against his former team. But it'll be interesting to see kind of how this game goes. And again, rivalry game. Hopefully we have a lot on our plate here to get up and play for. Anyways, guys, that will do it for this episode. Thank you so much for watching. An incredible comeback win against a divisional opponent. I wouldn't say a rival in Boston, but a divisional opponent and one you always want to win against in the Boston Bruins. Again, we came off that 9-1 win against them earlier in the season, and then an incredible third period comeback in this episode. Fantastic stuff from our team. We're seeing so many different scenarios and how our team responds. It's really good. It's a lot of character building in these games. Again, thank you so much for watching. Hit like down below, comment on the video, subscribe to the channel if you're not already subscribed, and hit that notification bell so you guys can see these videos as soon as they upload. And as always, guys, catch you on the next one.